Hey guys, it's Laurelei Lee, and how long have Crewy been sitting on this pun for? Because it seems like such an obvious pun, but we're only just now seeing it. Yeah, this episode is called The Grim Reaper. We're on episode 7 of volume 6. Last episode was a doozy and a half. I haven't been that stressed out watching an episode since the finale of volume 4. When, like, death flags were waving like crazy. But, yeah. Crewby took us through a bit of a horror movie sidetrack in the last episode with the apathy living under Bartleby's house, which apparently is based off of the fairy tale of Bartleby the Scrivener. Didn't know that until I watched the Crewby episode for last week, but, yeah. That was cool to find out. So now they have escaped the death house and are on their way back toward Argus. So hopefully they can catch up with the others soon and, you know, not be separated from the rest of their party. But got some interesting plot points from last episode. Crow's alcoholism is becoming more of a problem. And that's breaks my heart. And you can tell Ruby's really getting fed up with everything, because, like, really, she's the most sane person in the group currently, or at least during that encounter, except for Maria. And we also got the backstory that we were kind of anticipating, that Maria does indeed have silver eyes, or did. So we need to find out a little more about that, about what happened to her. But now Ruby has a mentor that she wasn't anticipating, and I am really looking forward to going forward with that plotline, because it's been a while since Ruby herself has had some character development, so we're finally getting to know more about the Silver Eyes, and that's what we've been wanting for quite a while. So I'm going to stop babbling. And I'm gonna press play on today's episode. Okay. Stay close, move fast. The darkness cannot last. No hope. Once I want a Ruby song that's in my vocal range, because there really aren't any. Casey has a very high voice. Okay. We're here. Why?
Now you understand.
Oh, she's telling her everything.
I've got to get the relic before it can be secured in Atlas. It's the only way that Salem... It's the only way we can accomplish our goal. You're not the only one who wants Ruby dead. But unfortunately, Salem does not feel the same way.
Is Sinner gonna, like, fully separate from
Salem? Instructed not to kill her. But you...
Oh.
You have no such orders. You can do as you please.
She's gonna use Neo as an assassin?
Help me get to Atlas. Help me find her. And the rest is up to you.
Ugh. No. Neo, come on. She didn't kill Torchwick. That is the bridge of my nightmares. I am so afraid of heights. That's not ominous. Is that young Maria? Dang! She's got hand axes that are like magnetically locked to each other. She's just as much of a badass as we'd all anticipated. Oh my gosh. Turn it to stone. Like what happened to Kevin, the Grimm dragon.
Oh, that's a fancy trick now, isn't it? Afraid it comes with a price, though, love.
Honest.
I don't think you realize who I am.
Of course I do. You're the Grim Reaper. And these are the last 60 seconds of your life.
This chick is weird. But Maria was known as the Grim Reaper? That's amazing. That is so cool. Also, the design of her weapons are amazing. I said hand axes, but they're really like mini scythes. Like, you know. Grim Reaper, which also makes me interested that she's, you know, kind of mentoring RWBY now. Fellow scythe wielders. Oh! Oh! Oh, she blinded her!
It was a close call. I'll give you that. You know, the only reason my master wants you dead is because of your eyes. But seeing as you ain't got them no more, you might be able to convince me to spare your life. Well, I respect that. A fighter to the end.
Dang!
But I wasn't. I went into hiding soon after.
Can't believe it. You're the Grim Reaper. You were a legend.
Dang.
You disappeared.
How exactly does a legend just disappear?
You never used your name. Never showed your face. Lots of us thought you were just laying low. Eventually, we came to accept that you were probably dead. But the stories about you... I based my weapon off of yours. I wanted to be as good as the Grim Reaper.
Well, I'm nothing but a disappointment. So you're well on your way.
RWBY had Crow, and Crow had her.
Child.
As inspiration.
A hunter is supposed to protect others to the bitter end. But after I lost my eyes, I only ever looked after myself. Even after my surgery, I was too afraid to fight. Afraid someone would bind me again.
Well, it's hard
finish
to fight.
What the others started. You shouldn't aspire to be like me. Especially when some of you are clearly stronger already. It's comforting seeing that your generation seems up to the task of inheriting this world. I'm just sorry I didn't do more to leave it in better shape.
Well, maybe you can do something now. Teach me to use my powers the way you did.
Sean!
It's Sean!
Huh? How?
Hello?
RWBY! Oh, thank you! I've been checking my scroll for your signal since we made it to the city.
The city?
Huh? You're almost there! She has it in her phone! It's Vomit Boy! They made it! Oh, the sun's rising. Oh, it's gorgeous.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have arrived in Argus.
Well, you gotta get down that hill first.
Didn't I?
Yeah.
Oh, he's crying.
It's good to see you guys.
Oh, baby.
It's a lot bigger than I thought it would be.
It's actually one of the largest non-capital cities.
It's gorgeous.
No way. Oh, wait, wouldn't it be hard to settle something this big?
And in some ways, looks like San Francisco.
Until Mantle showed up. Wow. Early settlement attempts by Mistral didn't go well, but colonists from Mantle were able to help them brave the cold climate and return for goods that Solitas couldn't provide.
The two nations worked together to create a
Tristan Mist.
While it still falls under Mistral domain, Atlas keeps a military presence here to help keep the people safe and to keep trade between the two nations steady.
Well, until recently.
Yeah.
We should probably start looking for a ship.
So, where have you guys been staying?
There you are! Is that...
Hey, Sam.
I can't believe I'm meeting your sister!
Oh my goodness!
Oh, I can give you the rundown later.
Will you guys knock it off?
What? Tell me stories about my baby brother.
I am not a baby! That is a baby.
This is amazing!
So, Saffron, you're the only Ark living here?
Yep, moved the second I could. Jean and I are the only two living here. Yes, he just wanted to be like his big sis.
Oh my gosh!
Aw, you didn't deny it. Everyone, this is my wife, Terracotta.
Hey there.
Nice to meet you.
Why, hello there. Wow, quite a party, you weren't kidding. Hun, can I get some help, please?
And you're sure it's all right if we stay with you?
Of course. We're happy to house huntsmen and huntresses.
You all risk so much to keep people like us safe. It's the least we can do. Especially for such an elite huntsman like yourself. Although I will say I was surprised to learn you had students helping you. Is that even legal?
Of course. Think of it as an extended training mission. Trust me, I was a professor. Even went to the same academy as them. And let me tell you, these kids are way better than we were at their age. Well, not better than me, specifically. But a lot of students.
Shut up, there's food!
Excuse me, I'll be right back.
Hello? Is everything okay?
Oh, yeah, it will be. Terra's a technician for the town's relay tower. Unfortunately, the military's radar system is also housed there.
Guess what's been on the fritz lately and who's getting falsely blamed?
Oh.
So, what's your plan for tomorrow?
Well, we're trying to make our way to Atlas. We'll probably start with the military base.
So, we kind of already tried that, and it didn't go super great.
Come on, it couldn't be that bad.
I think you can. Oh my gosh, this episode, man. Oh! This episode, man. Oh my gosh. This might be one of my favorite episodes of RWBY in general. Like the fight scenes are what we come for, but stuff like this is why I stay. Like, oh my, everything in this episode. Everything! Oh my gosh. Okay, start from the beginning. So Cinder is still working for Salem, pretty much. Or at least she plans to continue working with Salem, even though she's not really happy with her because she doesn't want her to kill RWBY. So to get around that, she's basically hiring Neo as an assassin. So they're gonna try and get to Atlas to kill RWBY. I really wish that Neo wasn't joining up with Cinder. I feel like she would be good to have on the good guy's side. But yeah. And then Maria's backstory was just insane. Like, she was a huntress legend called the Grim Reaper. And that's the crow based his scythe off of her weapon. That's so cool. But that fight, man. It was cool to see how her silver eyes worked on the Nevermore, because as we saw with last episode with the apathy, RWBY's eyes just basically vaporized them instantly. But Maria turned the Nevermore to stone, pretty much. The thing is, though, I think that kind of proves that, like, the bigger the Grimm, the kind of less that the Silver Eyes do to it. I mean, it still does a lot, but, like, back at the Battle of Beacon, our good friend Kevin, the Grimm Dragon, was pretty much just frozen in place by RWBY's eyes, and I think probably it was similarly, like, turned to stone, like the Nevermore here. So, that was really cool to see, and that fight was awesome. Maria was such a badass, and she was so cool, and her opponent was, the fight, it said in the credits that her name was Talk, and she was a fawn. You can clearly tell they were kind of basing her around the crocodile from Peter Pan, especially with the timepiece and trying to fulfill her little bounty in under a minute. But using the clock in the fight was a great way to build up tension, because they had the sounds of the ticking mixed in with the music, and it was just so good. Like, that, the sound editing on that was incredible, and I, oh, so good, so good. I just keep saying so good, but it was, oh my gosh. But yeah, Maria, like, fully lost her eyes, because some little bounty huntress just cut her eyes out in a fight. Everyone was wondering if it was, like, something bigger than that, like, if it was, like, the silver eyes make you lose your eyesight, or if she had been targeted by one of Salem's people. But I'm so happy that she's gonna be sticking around with them. And, oh my gosh, Argus is gorgeous! Like, the art style, the design, like, props to the Krubi on this setting. It was gorgeous in every way. And I loved seeing them reunite with each other. How Nora immediately went for cute boy Ozpin, and that was, like, the cutest. And then everyone else hugging and reuniting, but Sean, my baby, he was crying, he was so worried about them. Oh, I love Sean, and I want him to have more moments to shine, because he deserves it. And then finding out that they were staying with one of his sisters. Oh my gosh. The picture of him and his sisters, where he's just holding a little sign that says help. It was the cutest thing ever. Oh my gosh. And I love seeing, like, sibling banter. So them, like, fighting with each other was just adorable. But yeah, it was really happy to have that little, like, breather after the past 5 episodes. we really haven't had a breather yet this volume. It's been, like, one thing after another, and just increasingly getting darker, so I'm glad that we had this kind of breath of fresh air before we move on into more. But now they've got to deal with the military, because apparently Atlas does not want to talk to them in the slightest, and also there's other stuff going on with the radio tower and everything, so we'll see how that goes. But yeah, I really love this episode. I love this episode so much, and it's like, oh. So good. But yeah, as always, thank you guys for watching. All links and everything are in the description. Patreon, PO Box, Discord, if you want to talk about RWBY throughout the week, as well as other stuff that we talk about on my channel. But yeah, so all the good stuff's down there. I love you guys so much, and I will see you guys next week.